الحمد لله ما دام الوجود له حمدا يبلغنا منه الرضا أبدا، ثم الصلاة على المختار سيدنا وآله الكرماء وصحبه الزهدا.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، ما بعد. Today we will talk about the most frequent dua that is ever mentioned in the Quran and recited in the Quran, and it is one of the earliest duas to be revealed, and it is the dua of Surah Al-Fatiha, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. This dua, if you think about it, there is no other dua that is said more often in any language by any civilization than this phrase, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And in fact, the surah itself, Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it in the Quran the seven frequently repeated verses. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِّنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. I have given you, Ya Rasulullah, the seven oft repeated verses and the magnificent Quran. So it is as if Allah is saying, I've given you Fatiha and the Quran, even though the Fatiha is a part of the Quran, because no other surah is recited even in the same ballpark area as the Fatiha. Think about it. Every single rak'ah of every single salah that every single Muslim ever prays, the fard rak'ah, the nafil rak'ah, tahajjud, qiyam, istikhara, sunnah, tahiyyatul masjid, the two after tawaf, any rak'ah that you pray, you must recite Fatiha. And therefore, on average, the practicing Muslim will be reciting Fatiha at least 30 times a day. And that's not in the month of Taraweeh, in the month of Ramadan. In Ramadan, you get 50 times a day. On average, the semi-religious Muslim will be reciting Fatiha 10,000 times a year at minimum. In a lifetime, around a million or a little bit less than a million on average. If you do even a ballpark calculation, every day the Fatiha is recited billions of times. In a year, it is recited hundreds of trillions of times by mankind. There is no piece of human literature, there is no poem, there is no holy book that even comes close to Surah Al-Fatiha. And what is the purpose of Fatiha? What is the main verse of Fatiha? It is the dua, اهدنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And this is explicit in a number of traditions. Of them, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting with Jibreel once, and a door opened from Jannah, and an angel came down, and he said salam to them. Jibreel turned to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, this angel, this is the first time he is coming down to this earth, and that door that opened, it opened for the first time to send this angel down. What did the angel say? The angel said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah has sent me to tell you that you have two glad tidings, bushra, two good news that I have given you that I have not given any other prophet before you. And every verse that you recite of these two blessings, you will get it. The first of them, Surah Fatiha, and the second of them, the last verses of Surah Baqarah. These two verses, the angel is saying, are unique to you. No one before you has been given them. And the angel said, the mu'min who recites this dua, the believer who recites this passage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him what he wants. And what is the whole request of Fatiha? اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. There's only one request. There's only one dua, one phrase in there. Guide us to the صراط المستقيم. Also, we have in the famous hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu that he said, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that Allah says, this is now hadith Qudsi, the highest level of hadith in terms of barakah, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is narrating something from Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ. I have made the salah between myself and my servant in half, and I will give my servant what he asks. So when my servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah says, my servant has praised me. When he says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah says, my servant has magnified me. When he says, Maliki Yawmiddin, Allah says, my servant has glorified me. When the servant says, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een, you alone do we worship, you alone do we ask for help, Allah says, this is between me and my servant. And now, this is what Allah is saying, and now my servant will get whatever he asks for. Then what is the servant asking? اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. This dua is the most oft repeated dua of any Muslim. We must understand this significance, and we must recite Fatiha therefore with that ikhlas and taqwa, because we want to get this hidayah. So what is the request? And we also learn, by the way, even etiquette, by the way, bit of a tangent here, but we learn even the etiquettes of dua. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim occurs in the fourth verse. By the time we got there, what have we done? We have praised Allah. Alhamdulillah, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Maliki yawm al-Din. You do not just jump in and say, oh Allah, I want this. That's not right adab. You begin your dua by praising Allah. You raise your hands up and you first and foremost magnify Allah, glorify Allah. That is of the etiquettes of dua. You do not just ask immediately. That goes against etiquette and manners. The first thing you do, you begin by praising Allah. You mention His names and attributes. You say who you are. Oh Allah, I am your abd, you are my Rabb. Oh Allah, I am your servant. So you lay forth the foundation, the muqaddimah. You give the introduction before you ask your need, and then when it is appropriate, you then move on to your need. And what is your need in this surah? Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. What a beautiful dua, because it is so comprehensive. Guide us to the straight path. And this is again a very, very deep verse, because the word used in Arabic is sirat. And sirat is not sabil or tariq. It's a very unique word. And it only occurs in the singular, by the way, in the Quran. It never occurs in the plural. By the way, the English word street and the Arabic sirat, they seem to go back to the same cognate. So they shared the same cognate. That's why street, and in Latin it was strata, which it comes from. And sirat and strata, they have the same cognate. So the point being that sirat here, what does sirat in Arabic mean? It means the wide level path that has milestones, it has well illuminated, well marked, lot of people travel it. The sirat is the main highway. This is what the sirat is. The word sabil and tariq, these are smaller paths. And the sirat is the big path. It is the path that is straight. It is the path that goes without going up and down. It is a sirat al-mustaqim. Mustaqim here doesn't just mean straight. It means wide, and it means something that doesn't have peaks. You don't have to go up and down. It's not difficult. So the sirat al-mustaqim, what exactly is it? It is the path to the pleasure of Allah. As Allah says in the Quran, that هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. This is my way that I'm calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that worship Allah alone, and that وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا. This is the sirat that is mustaqim. So when we ask Allah, guide us to the straight path, it is a comprehensive dua that encompasses our theology, our belief, our actions, and our morals. Because to be on the straight path, you must have the right belief. To be on the straight path, you must have the right spiritual state. To be on the straight path, you must have the right deeds. And to be on the straight path, you must have the right akhlaq. So this shows us another etiquette of dua. We should ask duas that are comprehensive and not very specific. This is also we learned from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Du'as should be, in Arabic we call them jami', which means comprehensive. It should not be too nitpicky and specific, because then we are playing games and we are doing things that might be unbecoming. We should ask generically, oh Allah, I want Jannah. It is mentioned that once one of the tabi'un, he made dua to Allah, that, oh Allah, I want the big palace that will be white in color, that will be on the right hand side as soon as you enter Jannah. And the teacher said to him, ya Bunay, oh my son, ask Allah for Jannah, you will get all that is in it. Don't be this nitpicky that you are making conditions upon Allah. It is against the etiquette to go so narrow-minded. You be generic. Oh Allah, I want forgiveness. Oh Allah, I want rahmah. Oh Allah, I want Jannah. Oh Allah, I want the sirat al-mustaqim. Because the broader your dua, the more things come into it, and the more Allah will then give you. Why are you narrowing the infinite mercy of Allah? Why are you specifying when Allah Himself is al-wasi? واسع. So we say اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And this includes your manners, your theology, your akhlaq. It includes your actions with others. It includes your ibadat. All of it will be on the صراط المستقيم. Also notice in the etiquettes we learn over here, when we say اهدنا, which is in the plural, this also shows us, even though we are reciting Quran as individuals, and if the Quran had come اهدني, then this would be allowed, and some of the du'as are individual, but in this du'a we say اهدنا. Why? Because we are showing that, oh Allah, we want to be with the groups that are guided. We don't want to be individual. And we want guidance for ourselves, and we want guidance for others as well. We want to share. We don't want to be selfish with guidance. We want mankind to be guided. We want all of us to be guided. Why should I be stingy when it comes to Allah's mercy? Oh Allah, guide all of us to the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And this shows us that we have to have a love of other people, a genuine desire of wanting good for other people. So we make dua, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide all of us, myself, my family, my loved ones, my friends, my neighbors, all of humanity. Why can't we make dua for everybody? The Quran is saying, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Guide us all to the صِرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And then of course the clarification occurs, what is the صِرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ? It is the صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. It is the path of those whom your blessings, your favors have come to. It is the path of those whom you are pleased with. Because mankind is divided into three categories. Number one, those whom Allah is pleased with. Number two, those whom Allah is angry with. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Number three, those who they might be sincere, but they're doing things that are wrong. So Allah is not pleased with them, and Allah is not cursing them as well. But they're doing the wrong things. They haven't gotten there, yet still they're not accursed by Allah. Because they might be sincere, but they're not yet guided. So غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ are those who they are insincere. They are the hypocrites. They know the truth and they reject it. They're too arrogant to accept the truth. That is مَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Those are the accursed. وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. The ضَالِّينَ are those who they might not know the truth, and they sincerely are following something, but what they are following is not the truth. So they're not rejecting the truth knowingly. They're not rejecting the truth having recognized it, but they're still not upon the truth, so they're still misguided. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Also notice, before we get to the dua, اِهْدِنَا, what is the word? What is the verse? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And with this verse we actually conclude, because it gets us to our topic of dua. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. O Allah, we worship you alone. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And O Allah, we ask you of help alone. Notice, we worship you, we ask you of your help. The asking of help is in fact the essence of the worship. We worship you and we ask you for your help. The asking of the help, isti'ana, is the essence of worship. It is the beginning of worship. It is how worship begins. You ask Allah for worshiping Him. You ask Allah for hidayah. We worship Allah by asking His help to worship Him. This is how the verse can be translated. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Then what is that isti'ana? What is the asking? اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. So the beginning of all worship is dua. Dua is how we begin anything, even the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dua, as we said, is the essence of worship. And so in Surah Al-Fatiha, we constantly make dua to Allah for this comprehensive aspect of hidayah. And I forgot to mention one beautiful hadith. I have to add this here. In Salat al-Tahajjud once, one of the wives of the Prophet overheard him in the middle of the night. He didn't know anybody was paying attention. He didn't know anybody else was listening to him. He was in tahajjud. He thought one of our mothers was asleep. She overheard. She narrated that in the middle of the night, I woke up, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam make this dua in tahajjud. Allahumma rabba Jibreel wa Mika'il wa Israfil. O Allah, the Lord of Jibreel, the Lord of Mika'il, the Lord of Israfil. Fatir as-samawati wal ard. You are the one who originated the heavens and earth. Alim al-ghaybi wa shahada. You know the hidden, you know the unseen. أَنْتَ تَحْكُمُ بَيْنَ عِبَادِكَ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. You are the one who judges between the people when they differ. O Allah, اهدني, guide me O Allah, اهدني لما اختلف فيه من عبادك, O Allah, guide me لما اختلف فيه من الحق, excuse me, guide me to whatever your servants have differed between بإذنك, because you are the one, إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط المستقيم, you guide whomever you want to the صراط المستقيم. I find this dua to be mind-boggling. Our Nabi, our Rasul, the Mustafa, the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is saying, O Allah, matters are confusing, your servants differ about everything, you are the one who guides, O Allah, so I want you to guide me when the people are differing over things, I don't know truth from falsehood. اهدني لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك. O Allah, with your idhn, I want to be guided to the sirat al-mustaqim, because no one guides to the sirat al-mustaqim other than you, and indeed of the names of Allah is Al-Hadi, the one who guides. So we make dua to Allah, Ya Hadi, ihdina al-sirat al-mustaqim, for no one guides to the straight path other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Ya Nabi, salam alayka. Ya Rasul, salam alayka. Ya Habib, salam.